Good morning everybody. In this video, we will study about tsunami, the earth's pandemonium. Pandemonium means it's a wild and noisy type of confusion or disorder created. So tsunami is wild and noisy, so it is termed as pandemonium. Now this term tsunami is a Japanese term which means harbor waves. It is termed as harbor waves because when tsunami comes, it destroys the harbor. Harbor means the place where ships take rest. So harbors are destroyed in tsunami, so that's why it is called as harbor waves. Such a tsunami occurred in Indian Ocean on 26 December 2004. And the epicenter of that was Sumatra. So this tsunami occurred due to earthquake that occurred in Sumatra. Now this is India and this is Sumatra. Of course it will be little difficult to see from there, but even then you can guess this is India and this is Sumatra and this is Indian Ocean. So the earthquake which occurred in Sumatra caused the tsunami. So in the earthquake which was caused under the ocean or in under the Indian Ocean near Sumatra, it was of 9.0 in Richter scale. 9.0 is a very huge earthquake. So when this earthquake occurred, so there are tectonic plates between many continents. So there is a tectonic plate in between India and Burma also. So one tectonic plate, that is Indian plate, that moved under the Burmese plate. So Indian tectonic plate moved inside the Burmese tectonic plate. So Burma tectonic plate is a small tectonic plate. So when this movement took place, a vibration occurred, or because of this vibration a sudden earthquake occurred. When earthquake occurred under the ocean, there is ocean floor. So a gap was created in the ocean floor and that gap was almost 10 to 20 meters. So when a gap was created of 10 to 20 meters between these two tectonic plates, at that time to fill the gap, the water from all sides of the Indian Ocean rushed towards this area where the tectonic plates have moved. So water from all sides rushed towards or in between the Indian Ocean, towards the interior of the Indian Ocean, and the water from the coastal areas moved towards inside. That means from the South and Southeast Asia, from all these portions, the water started moving towards the Indian Ocean. Now, when it occurred, all the water came together inside that Indian Ocean to fill the gap. And as soon as the gap was filled, the water rushed towards the coastal areas with a very high speed of almost 800 to 900 kilometers per hour. So from the epicenter, it started moving towards the coastal areas with great speed. And due to this great speed, many of the islands which are located in the Indian Ocean got submerged by this water or due to tsunami. In India, all of you know we have an Andaman and Nicobar Island. So the last point of Andaman and Nicobar Island is called as Indira Point, which is called as the south point of the India. So this last point of India, or the southernmost point of India, was also submerged underwater due to this tsunami. Now, this epicenter, from the epicenter, that is from Sumatra, the water started moving towards Andaman and Nicobar Islands and also towards Sri Lanka. Now the wavelength was more when it started in Sumatra, but when it reached the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and towards Sri Lanka, the wavelength started decreasing. So the wavelength decreases according to the depth of the water, and so it became 70 kilometers per hour. When it reached the coastal area, the depth of 70 kilometers it moved towards 3 kilometers inside the inland area. So all the 3 kilometer area, the water moved inside the land, and this 3 kilometer area was totally destroyed due to water or due to tsunami waves. And when the water entered almost 3 kilometer inside, almost 10,000 people were killed. Then many of the houses were destroyed, and the coastal areas of Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Puducherry, Andaman and Nicobar Islands were especially affected due to this. And usually in such type of tsunamis cannot be predicted, because earthquakes cannot be predicted. But a warning system is placed in the Indian, in the Pacific Ocean, which can give a idea about the coming tsunami or earthquake at least 3 hours before. But no such mechanism is there in Indian Ocean, because it is very rare to occur tsunami in the Indian Ocean. So that is why no such system was placed, and so people did not come to know about such a tsunami. And but in Pacific Ocean it's common, so they have put a warning system there. So this tsunami was caused in 2004, which created a lot of destruction, especially in the coastal areas. The people in the coastal areas were unaware of such problems, so they were not prepared for such a disaster. Moreover, that 26 December was Christmas time, so many of the visitors came near the Indian Ocean to enjoy the sea breeze and all. So at that time, when the river water receded inside, when a sudden earthquake occurred in the Sumatra area, and as I told you, ocean floor displaced and a gap of 10 to 20 meters were created. So the water rushed from the ocean side towards inside the ocean. So the people saw that the water is going back towards the ocean. So this scene was so much fascinating for the visitors who were there in the coastal areas, standing and watching the sea go back, so or the ocean water going back. So they moved inside the sea to watch that, and when the sudden water came back, these people did not get time to reach the shore, and so many people were killed who were there in the sea beaches. So that caused more destruction and more lives were lost because of that. So this is all about tsunami.